also been in Rwanda for a few years, so I imagine where you're coming from.
Yeah.
But obviously, all their crops are down the hills as well, which is never easy. It's obviously that to run down the hill. I think I'm going to come from it very much from an obesity point of view. We're chairing the All Party Group on Obesity, which we're about to kickstart again after the few weeks away from Parliament. But also, as a mental health select committee, we produced a report that was called Asking the Government to Take Bold and Brave Action on Obesity. And I was quite pleased that we did highlight that obesity is one form of malnutrition. People do say it's not what you eat, it's more what you eat. I think we've really seen that from what we were saying, that it's actually people with obesity are often taking the wrong positions. And I think that's really illustrated by the fact that you get higher levels of obesity in the most deprived communities in the UK. And I think it's really, when you hear the stats that at the moment when a child starts school, one in five of them are likely to be overweight or obese. And by the time they leave from primary school to go to secondary school, one in three are likely to be overweight or obese. And I think the data is that by 2020, 60% of boys in the most deprived areas will be overweight or obese, compared to, in fact, 16% of boys from areas that aren't deprived. So there's this big divide between the deprived areas and the better off areas, which I find really, really something we need to, if you start to address the health inequalities, you start to address them in different issues, and it is much of everything being joined up. And it's also, you know, it's about nutrition, it's also about the long-term impacts of that on health. I've found out recently that type 2 diabetes is being diagnosed in teenagers. And that was always seen previously as a disease of the older age. And with that, it brings cardiovascular disease, it brings renal disease, sight loss, it brings high risk of cancers. So the long-term implications of not getting it right in childhood and getting nutrition right is really worrying. I think the child abuse strategy or the plan came out, and that actually was very disappointing. Even though I'm a certain member of Parliament, very critical of the government, so I thought they had that opportunity to go further. So the Health Committee, Select Committee, that should send to bold and brave, and they weren't. I feel that they, talking to the Health Minister since that, I'm pleased that you're having discussions as well. I think it's a matter of trying to do things one step at a time so people weren't overwhelmed. I think there's lots of other measures that can be taken. The advertising issue is one thing that the Health Select Committee recommended, to actually prevent advertising junk food before the 9 o'clock watershed, and we're still looking for that. At the moment it's actually banned on children's TV, but we've all sat and watched the Saturday evening programmes and seen all sorts of unhealthy products flash up, but it's got to influence, and it's so hard for parents to actually say no when it's actually being advertised on TV. So I think, obviously, as an influence of what you have to say, I think it's really good that we seem to be all talking from the same book, which is really important. I'm sure there'll be more things that come out later, but that's sort of really where I'm coming from. I think we're really talking about the same issues and wanting to move in the same direction.
Thanks, Malnutrition.